It's time for the match game. Hollywood Squares, our with the stars of St. Elsewhere. Kim Miyori. Howie Mandel. Nancy Stafford. Eric Laneuville. Begley, Jr. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Through the door.
Hi.
You're beautiful.
Finally.
Don't have a chance.
Thank you all. It's really a marvelous treat for us this week to have the stars of St. Elsewhere on with us. This is only Tuesday, but those of you who saw the Monday show, you know it was pretty nifty, wasn't it?
It was fun. We had a good time.
Yes, you were wonderful, weren't you?
Oh, thank you. I love your work. Don't ever change.
All right, I won't. Are you still hungry?
I didn't get a chance to eat lunch, and I just, so now I had the opportunity to eat lunch, and thanks.
Right.
It was great, the hors d'oeuvres that you served backstage. And
incidentally, I meant to say yesterday, those of you who had the string beans during the dinner break, the food break, they had string beans were loaded with garlic. Did we all have them?
I hope so.
If we all had them, it's okay. But if somebody, one of us didn't have them, it's going to be difficult. Oh, thank you. May I have a spritz of that?
I need better glasses.
I'll say.
We're covered.
Powerful stuff. All right, let's get underway by greeting our two players over here, Valerie Gordon and George Strine. All right, we'll find out who you are and where you're from. Valerie, tell us about you, please.
I am currently employed as a human relations representative for a motorcycle helmet manufacturer. I am married and my
Hold on. Now you can't slide that one back.
I'm going to get that by us.
You're a human relations
representative
for a motorcycle manufacturer.
Helmet. Motorcycle helmet manufacturer.
Yes. Now, what does that mean? Tell us what that means.
And who's
that
in charge of the animal relations?
Right.
Yes.
That means I'm in the personnel office, and I'm responsible for different activities and the personnel at the company that I work with.
I don't understand a word you're saying, Valerie. But let's move on.
Okay, let's get on to the
married
part. I'm married, and my husband and I enjoy traveling and taking care of our family, which consists of our animals, no children, and we also like to take care of strays and find homes for them.
That's wonderful.
Thank you.
Really is great. Good for you. All right, let's hear about George, shall we?
After I graduated from law school, I became a private investigator, and now I'm currently working as a freelance writer and a professional bodyguard.
Really?
Yes.
When you were a private investigator, did you wear raincoats and have meetings with blonde...
One of the reasons I got out of it is deadly dull.
It's boring.
It's boring.
So
it's not Magnum P.I.
It's not Mike Hammer or any of those things?
No.
All right.
Good, they're all on other networks.
Right.
That's why I mentioned it.
Attaboy.
All right, we're going to have three shots at making as many matches as you can with the stars here, and the one who's ahead at the end of the third round will be the winner and go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Valerie, you won the toss, so we'll ask you to go first.
Well, I'd like to try A.
You want to try A?
I'll try it.
That's this one.
That's that one.
You sure?
I'm pretty sure.
You don't want B. B is a bargain today.
Then I'll try A.
All right, A is what you want, A is what you get. Here's what it says. The dentist is speaking. And the dentist said, I finally found a way to get Fat Frida to use her water pick. Instead of water, I got her one that squirts blank. Now, the operative word is Fat Frida. Fat Frida is the operative word here. Found a way to get her to use her water pick. Instead of water, I got her one that squirts blank.
Did
didn't play Match Game yesterday.
Well, this is his first shot at it.
He's a virgin.
Oh, yes. All right. Here we go, Valerie. The dentist said I finally found a way to get fat-free to use her water pick. Instead of water, I got her one that squirts blank.
The only thing I could think of is ice cream.
Ice cream would be fattening. Be hard to squirt out of ice cream, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Might be a little difficult.
Kind of difficult getting that through the water pick.
I would think it'd be a little too thick, wouldn't it?
I put myself in fat-free place and decided I'd like chocolate milk.
Chocolate milk? Oh, boy, I'd do that. I'm old. Ooh, that sounds good to me.
Come on.
I'm with you, Kim. What do you got?
I went with a very heavy girl for a while. She looked kind of like a side of beef with teeth. She was very heavy. She had her portrait done one time by Rand McNally. You talk about heavy. No, I'll get right to the answer. Enough of these bad jokes. I said whipped cream. I was half there.
Whipped cream. Rand McNally, eh?
Oh, yeah.
All right, Nancy?
Don't ask me where I came up with this one. I said guacamole.
Guacamole. You know, that's
I
one
agree.
Of the
You're right.
most fattening things
it.
You can eat is guacamole.
Sure.
People don't realize it's extraordinarily high in calories.
Absolutely.
That's where it came
yes.
from.
Fat Frida Fernandez.
Fat Frida. What have you got for Fat Frida?
I said, just like Nancy's, I said chocolate.
Chocolate.
Good answer.
Valerie's looking for ice cream,
Good
Eric.
Answer.
What have you got for her?
Good answer. Chocolate.
There it is.
Oh, no wonder he liked it.
I know Frida, and Frida is a pig.
Oh, really?
I know her.
There must be a gentler way of stating that.
No, she is a pig, but she always wears a helmet, and that's the important thing. But I said it squirts food.
Food?
Well, brisket coming out of a water pick paints a nice picture in my head. Can you see that?
Beef fat, fat beef brisket.
Shut up. Just shut up. Idiots.
They're saying food.
Now, George, let's see what we have for you here. This is your first round questions. Mayor Jones said, I'm the mayor of the sleaziest town in the world. Get your own act. Sleaziest town in the world. Other places have topless waitresses. In our town, we have topless blinks. Ready? All right, George. Mayor Jones said, I'm the mayor of the sleaziest town in the world. Other places have topless waitresses. In our town, we have topless blanks.
Councilman.
Councilman. All right. Anything, you know. Postman, cops, all that stuff. Connected with the city. What do you say?
Something a little more provocative. Meter maids.
Aha! Wonderful. Hey, what do you say we all move to Kim's town? All right, Ed.
I wouldn't mind seeing some of our city council topless here. Baxter Ward, without a couple. Could be interesting. Policeman.
Policeman, that's a good one. Yes. All right, Nancy.
Yay. I agree with Ed. Policeman.
So we have two policemen.
Yeah.
All right, she's looking for a councilman.
Possible I missed the point of this question. I said waiters.
Waiters.
Affirmative action by the audience. Thank you so much.
Right. Eric?
I said councilmen, councilwomen, councilperson.
Aha.
Yeah.
Hello, Howie.
At first, I was thinking bread and bicycle. And then I said to myself, that makes no sense.
That's
so
right.
Then I said waiters.
Topless waiters.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we have two of those. So there we are at the end of round one. 1-0. George is ahead here. Round two coming up in a moment. First this. Here we go with round two. George, you're ahead. We ask you to go first.
B, please.
B it is for you, sir. Michael Jackson said. Anybody do Michael Jackson? You do a high voice? Can you do Michael Jackson?
I do a high voice, but it's
well, that's okay. Close enough. Close enough. I'll do this part. You do the part and quote. Okay. Michael Jackson said,
I don't think that my brothers like me anymore. They just stuck my...
blank.
In the trash compactor.
Thank you, Michael. I don't think my brother. You don't understand a word of that? He said, I don't think my brothers like me anymore. They just stuck my blank in the trash compactor. Here we go. Oh, there you are. Michael Jackson said, I don't think my brothers like me anymore. They just stuck my blank in the trash compactor.
My sunglasses.
Sunglasses. He's famous for those, right? All right. Well, that's okay. What did you say?
Sunglasses.
Yeah. See how okay it is? Very good, Kim.
I'm different from other contestants. I said glove.
Glove, yeah. I would think that would be the big answer, glove.
It would be very mean to stick his glove in the car.
Yeah. All right. Hello, John.
Hi, Gene.
They just stuck my blank in the trash compactor.
Very
what do you say
conscious.
To that?
I said, my lovely new nose.
Nose.
Whoa.
That would hurt. Ooh. All right, Eric, we're up to you.
Sorry, Mike.
He doesn't have it.
You don't play. Okay.
I would have said glove.
Right, you would have said glove. Howie, what'd you say?
I just want to say hello to everybody in the balcony. And I also said glove.
All right.
Thank you, Lionel Richie.
So, one pair of sunglasses, George. So you've picked up one more. You're up to two. Valerie, time for you to start doing a little catching
eight.
Up. Let's see if you go. Harold said, he said, my new wife, the traffic cop, is always thinking about her job. On our wedding night, she brought along a sign that said, blank. All right. Valerie. Harold said, my new wife, the traffic cop, is always thinking about her job. On our wedding night, she brought along a sign that said, blank.
Stop.
Stop. All right. I like that one.
Stop.
Stop, yes.
No, slow.
Slow. Aha. Aha. All right, Kim. We'll talk later. Ed?
Traffic cop is a key part of it here. I was thinking more in the terms of meter maid, so I said no parking. Why don't I miss it?
No parking.
Why don't I miss it?
No, that's interesting. If you think about that,
yeah.
It's a very interesting answer.
Violation or expired, maybe?
Yes, right.
That is an interesting answer.
It is. Have you got an interesting one?
I think she's sort of shy, so I thought no parking, too.
No parking. All right. So, Valerie is looking for a stop sign.
I'd like to comment on my last answer. You see, Michael, I never had that nose job I always wanted. I said stop.
And away you go. One for Valerie. Eric says
stop.
That's two for Valerie. Howie, are you going to burst her bubble?
I thought, you know, police, arrest. I said, spread them.
Okay.
Wedding night.
So there we are at the end of round two. It's all tied up 2-2. Round three right after this. Here we go to round three. Now, since the score is tied and he went first last time, Valerie, you go first this time.
Okay, let's try A.
All right, here we go with A. At the nudist camp, Officer Ned said, it's tough being a naked cop. The hardest part of my job is finding a place to put my blank.
Good for the next question.
There we go. Valerie, at the nudist camp, Officer Ned said, it's tough being a naked cop. The hardest part of my job is finding a place to put my blank.
The only thing I could think of is hat.
Hat?
It's the only thing I could think of.
Now, wait a minute.
I must have misunderstood the question.
Hold on, wait a minute.
She's in the helmet business.
Helmet, yeah.
Now, you see, if you were standing there, well, let's say George is standing there, totally naked, right? Now, what would be so difficult about putting his hat on his head? That would be easy, wouldn't it?
It would.
But there are other things that a policeman carry that if he were naked, it would be difficult to find a place to put them, such as?
Well, one of two things. Is that a pistol in your pocket or?
Gun.
Gun.
Where would he put the gun?
I said badge.
Badge. Yeah.
Where you get a pin?
Ouch, 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 a badge.
A badge. All right.
I said, this is probably, I wanted to think of thinking cop again, and I was thinking, like, even problems maybe during the day, where to put his nightstick.
Right. All right. May I make an inquiry about this?
This is my lucky thing.
It's luck, that brings you luck?
Yeah, say, what's your name? Say that.
What's your name? Okay, I got the idea. That's, thank you.
It doesn't stop.
Oh.
It doesn't stop.
Cut!
I don't have control. I'm being serious. You shouldn't have asked me.
Turn it up. Let me have that thing.
I can't. I'll just keep it.
No, you can't do that. You gotta give it to me. Okay. George, you're up.
I need it.
Oh, we didn't.
What?
Oh, never mind.
He showed, didn't he?
Pardon me?
Yeah, he showed. Yeah.
What do you think?
The loser is going to get this. No, I'm only kidding. Here we go. Last chance to break the tie here, George. 2-2. Old Lady Perkins said, when I was young, the boys used to drink champagne out of my slipper. Now that I'm 102 years old, the old men drink blank out of my slipper. Old Lady Perkins. Here we go. George, Old Lady Perkins said, when I was young, the boys used to drink champagne out of my slipper. Now that I'm 102 years old, the old men drink blank out of my slipper.
Geritol.
Geritol! Geritol. Geritol it is. What do you say?
Enough clowning around. Give this fellow the lead.
Geritol wins the game. That's it. What's the rest of you have? Pleasure to meet you.
We're
gonna send some gifts to you for the match game. Mallory Gordon, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes. Hey there. Get it? Now, we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares. We're going to bring on three more stars here. John and I will trade places. And we've got lots more excitement coming along, friends. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Panasonic's 13-inch color television. Features include remote control, sleep timer, and on-screen display channel. Timer or even time of day furnished by Panasonic. Of the match game, Hollywood Squares. Power with more of the stars of St. Elsewhere. Norman Lloyd. Ellen Reed. Terence Knox. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bauman.
You got it.
Okay, we'll be back to play Hollywood Squares in just a minute. Don't miss it.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
6-4. 6-4, huh? Thank you. Welcome to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. This guy's 6'4". His name is George Strine. That was a very good old man that you did there. We will do the jokes and the accents. Tom Selleck never gets to do that. Okay. And we also have three brand new celebrities. Where are they? Yes, from St. Elsewhere. They are Norman, Ellen, and Terence. Welcome. Ellen Bree.
Yes.
Yesterday, we almost got to talk about this on the air, and I thought it was kind of interesting. I never knew why they call St. Eligius, which is the name of the hospital, St. Elsewhere. You probably got this all out of the way in the first episode, but what's the answer?
Well, the answer is, actually, St. Elsewhere is a very common slang term that a lot of medical people, medical students, residents, interns use, doctors. The Mount St. Elsewheres of the world are the dumping ground hospitals, the large city hospitals that all the prestigious hospitals, when they get a case that they don't really want, they say send them elsewhere. The Mount St. Elsewheres, the dumping grounds where you wouldn't even want to send your mother-in-law.
Hmm. Interesting. Well, Match Game was not a dumping ground for you. Let's see how you do in Hollywood Squares. Come on, George. Welcome once again to our defending champion. Her name is Janet Stafford. She has $3,975. And it's her fourth day today.
Right.
So the question burning in your mind is, how am I going to get into the big bucks? Yesterday you told us a little bit about your planned strategy. Have you done what you promised?
Yes, I still have my underwear wrong side out.
All right, we'll see if it helps today.
Have you tried wearing your bra backwards?
Well, it wouldn't make a difference anyway.
We're going to play Hollywood Squares until you hit the time's up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point goes on to play Super Match for over $30,000. First game is worth $100, $25 for every square. Champ, you get to start. Let's go.
Ed, please.
Ed Begley Jr.
Yes.
When Benji acts in his movies, do they use a stunt dog, or does Benji do all his own stunts?
Let's see. Lassie, they had a lot of different Lassies, I know.
That's not the question,
is it, Terence? So thank you for reminding me. A bitter, bitter man. I'm not sure why. I believe there's only one Benji. I believe that they have one Benji for all the work. Yes, Benji, one.
Ed wants to believe in only one Benji. Agree or disagree, Janet, for the first square? Do they?
I agree.
Benji does his own stunts. You are right to agree. You get the square, and you're up to a good start.
Even the stunt driving,
yes.
Wow.
George Strine, pick a star if you dare.
Norman, please.
Norman Lloyd, one of the chiefs of St. Elsewhere. Your plumbing has just sprung a tiny little leak, Norman.
I hear you.
That's why we seat you behind that desk. According to the People's Emergency Guide, what should you plug the hole with? A round wooden toothpick or a glob of poly grip?
Benji. Did you say it's my plumbing?
It's one's plumbing.
Your one's plumbing.
Anyone's plumbing, yes.
I would say, and it's a small leak.
Just a tiny little leak.
Yeah.
Now that you bring it
well,
up.
Well, for one, that tiny. I'd say a toothpick.
Agree or disagree, George?
I'll disagree.
You should plug that tiny little leak with a round wooden toothpick. You should have agreed with Norman. Your opponent gets that square.
I'm an old plumber.
All right, you're off to a good start. You have done this before, Janet Stafford. You're playing X. Make your move.
Howie to win.
Howie Mandel to win.
All right.
Howie, would you see more moons around the planet Jupiter? Or would you see more moons if the Three Stooges dropped their pants?
If they were, are they wearing their underwear inside out?
We're not privy to that information,
okay.
Howie.
Jupiter has eight moons. So Jupiter, it would have to be Jupiter has eight moons. Jupiter has eight moons and six stooges. So.
So there are more moons around Jupiter.
There are more moons around Jupiter than stooges.
Agree or disagree, Janet?
I'll agree.
For the game. You agree?
I agree.
There are more moons around Jupiter.
Oh, okay.
You're right, you're right. You get the square.
Go out and get yourself some underwear.
Queens, clean sweep. Three in a row. And here are the the statistics. The vital statistics. 17 moons around Jupiter. Of course, three moons.
How many stooges?
One for each stooge. Three moons. Okay, we're going to clear the board and move right on to the next game. That's good for you, but we got lots and lots of time. This one's worth $200. George, make your moves.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Here we go.
Which came first, Gene? Bugs Bunny or the rabbit test?
I believe the, let's see, Bugs Bunny. The Bugs Bunny was created long before. Now, wait a minute. Hold everything here, folks. Take two aspirin, call me in the morning. I believe the rabbit test was around longer.
Agree or disagree, George?
I'll agree.
The rabbit test was around longer. Yeah. Good for you. Right to agree. 1929.
Did you know that?
1929 for the rabbit test. Bugs Bunny, not until 1940. Ponder that while we ponder these messages. We'll see you in 2 minutes.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
One solitary O, but it's a big one for you because it got you on the board. George, Janice, your move, you're playing X.
Ed, please.
Ed Begley, Jr.
Yes.
Your blind date just got a permanent, and her hair smells terrible. According to household hints expert Mary Ellen, to get rid of the odor, should you soak her head in vodka or in tomato juice?
This is a tough one. I would think the best thing, I assume it's some sort of a bleach that smells bad or something. Let me think. Oh, no, it's a permanent, right? Permanent.
Permanent.
I'm trying to think of the chemical to find out if it should be alkaline or acidic. That's what I'm trying to determine here.
Time limit.
And I'm going to say I think the tomato juice will take it out. The acidic, yes.
Agree or disagree, Janet?
I agree.
Tomato juice will take it out. Yes, you're right to agree. Right. And you get the square. Well done. If that doesn't work, soak your own head in vodka and you won't notice the smell. George, it's your move. You're playing O.
I'll go with Kim, please.
All right, Kim Miyori.
Hi.
Put an O. What are there more of in the U.S. today, Kim? Women MDs or male nurses?
That's an interesting question. I'll take a guess here. Let's go for women doctors.
This woman who plays a woman doctor says there are more women MDs. Agree or disagree, George?
I'll agree.
There are more women MDs. You're right to agree, and you get the square. Good going. About 60,000. 60,000 women MDs at this country.
And only
at this
one
in this country. Janet Stafford, you are a defending champ. You're playing X. He's got a couple of O's there.
Norman to block.
You missed this one. The game and the lead belongs to the challenger. Norman Lloyd, can dandruff cause baldness? Or does dandruff have nothing to do with it?
Is this a personal question?
I'm so sorry about this, Norman. It's pure coincidence.
Well, in view of the fact that it's a coincidence, I would say it has nothing to do with it.
Says dandruff has nothing to do with baldness. To block, agree or disagree, Janet?
I agree.
Dandruff has nothing to do with baldness. Yeah. Did it again. She blocked and stays alive in this game. Well done. That's why you're the champ. George Strange, you are thwarted in that position. Where would you like to move?
Howie to block, please.
Okay. Let's go, George.
You missed this one. It's a pretty big lead for Janet. Howie Mandel, how often does a female elephant make love?
Oh, that's easy. Well, with me, twice. And how often?
I got a couple of choices here. Is it every 4 days or every 4 years?
4 years if it's wearing its underwear inside out. No, because that turns off male elephants. But they're lucky. And I would say every 4 years, an elephant, because it's just so much trouble to check into a room. And you don't want to do that every 4 days.
He says every 4 years.
There are
George.
No surprises, though.
Female elephant makes love every 4 years for a very important block for you. Agree?
I'll agree.
A female elephant makes love every 4 years. You're right to agree. You get the square, and you do block. Well done.
to the
yes,
same
Howie.
To the same guy.
To the same guy. Janet, you are thwarted in that position, and it's your move.
Eric to block.
The shoe is on the other foot. You missed this one. George takes the game. Eric Laneuville, what lasts longer, the average American car or the average garbage truck?
Has to be the garbage truck.
Agree or disagree to block, Janet?
I agree.
The average American car lasts longer. No. That surprises me, too. Your opponent gets that square, and your opponent wins the game. Good going for you, George. Boy, is that a shocker. A garbage truck lasts only about 6 years. Congratulations, George. Well done. You have taken the game and the lead. We got a hot one going. $300 game coming up. Don't miss it. 300 to 225. Well, we'll find out if she really is on the ropes on her fourth day. Janet, you lost the last game. It means you get to start this one. Pick a star.
Ed, please.
Okay, this game is worth $300, so obviously everything hangs in the balance. Ed Begley Jr., when there is a power failure, what should you do with the limp sausage in your freezer? Should you cook it right away, or will the spices in the sausage preserve it for months?
If it's frozen, I think you have to eat it right away. I'd say you'd have to cook it right away.
Agree or disagree, Janet?
I agree.
You have to cook that sausage right away. Right to agree. Yes. You get the square. Good for you. There's one X up there. George Strine, your move. You're playing O.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Yes, I'm ready.
Is it possible for a man to have a hot flash, or do you have to be a woman to have one?
Well, the men's hormonal structure is different from women's, so therefore I don't believe it's possible. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, doctor.
You can get the vapors, but no hot flashes. No.
No. Not possible for a man to have a hot flash. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Men can have hot flashes, too. This is a formidable challenger. He is right to disagree, and he gets the square. He's tough. He's hanging in there. Your move, Janet.
Kim, please.
Kim Miyori. For your anniversary, your husband gave you a side of beef and the book, How to Be Your Own Butcher. Do you also need a saw, or can you do all your butchering with a knife?
Side of beef. I definitely need a saw to cut through the bones, of course.
Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
You do need a saw. That could be the pivotal question. We will find out. Your opponent gets that square. Two O's up there versus one X. George Strine, your move.
Norman to win, please.
This could give you a pretty big lead. Norman Lloyd, are there any striptease artists in Russia? Or is that a no-no in the Soviet Union?
Would you repeat that, please?
Are there any striptease artists in Russia? Or is that a no-no there?
Of course, one has to think about the weather there. It's very cold, isn't it? And could use furs. However, I would say no, there are none.
For the game, agree or disagree, George?
I'll agree.
That is a no-no in the Soviet Union. You're right. You get the square, you win the game. Attaboy. He doped it out. It is a yet, but it's yes for you, George. Congratulations, 675, 250 for the champ. There is still time. It's a $400 game. Take the O's and the X off the board. Janet, your move.
Ed, please.
Ed Begley, Jr., you're a man who lifts weights a lot. Could this cause you to get stretch marks or to lose brain cells?
You can get stretch marks.
Can you, Janet?
I agree.
You could get stretch marks. Right. You get the square. Pick a star, George.
Terence, please.
Yeah, well, it's about time, man.
Terence Knox, you'd love to make some popcorn, but you are out of oil. Instead, you use bacon grease. Now, according to Heloise, are you in for a delicious surprise or a greasy, rancid mess?
You know, that's not as easy as that sounds. You're in for a mess.
Agree.
You're in for a mess.
Agree or disagree, George?
I'll disagree.
You are in for a delicious surprise.
It's a delicious surprise for you. You were right to disagree. Excellent playing. You get the square. An X and an O are up there. Janet Stafford, he is really tough. Pick a star.
Howie, please.
Howie Mandel.
All right.
Okay. You're all alone, Howie, and you've just stepped into a pit of quicksand. Is it likely you can swim out of there, or are you history?
I'm Howie. And I'm just below a bunch of sand. And I guess if they wrote about it, it would be history.
So you are history if you step in a pit of quicksand.
Yeah.
Agree or disagree, Janet?
I agree.
You can swim out of a pit of history.
You can.
The jungle movies lied. The jungle movies have lied.
I swear, I wasn't lying.
Should have disagreed. Your opponent got that square. Time is up. $725. George Strine, you have done it. New champ. Congratulations. Attaboy.
All right. Thank you.
You have done what three people failed to do. You have dethroned Janet Stafford. Congratulations, George. Make your way over there. Join Gene Rayburn. Get set for your shot at the big money. Ah! Because in all your days here, you never quite got into the big money, but you're still an excellent champion. Janet Stafford leaving here $4,250. Congratulations. You're lovely.
Thank you.
Gene, take
care. Okay, John. Here we are with our new champ. We'll be back with him and our nine stars for a go at the $30,000 right after this.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gene. Here we go. George is all primed, and he's full of confidence, and we wish him well, and we hope he wins the money. All right, if you're ready, we'll have a go at the $30,000 right now. Good luck to you. We polled an audience not too long ago, a nice, smart bunch like these we have here today, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Kidney blank. If you give us the answer they gave most often, it's $1,000. For the second most popular, $500. For the third, $250. Any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance here. You may call on them one at a time.
Mr. Bauman.
There are three very good ones, I think. I'm going to choose kidney stone.
So there's one for you.
How's that? Good one.
Nancy.
Kidney bean.
Kidney bean.
I hesitate to do this, but Howie.
Howie, now the third spot is tough, but with a fertile imagination like yours, I'm sure you're going to come up with something. Oops, time is up. Thank you very much.
Transplant.
Kidney transplant. Oh, all right. There's a good one.
Where they take one bean and put it in another salad.
Two beans, right. So you have transplant, bean, and stone. You want one of those or one of your own?
I think I'm going to go with kidney stone.
Kidney stone, he says, is going to be up there under the big number. All right, let's investigate it right now and begin down at the bottom and reveal a $250 response. Kidney transplant. Right. I had a way to go, Howie.
I know.
Yeah, you know those things. All right, the $500 response says kidney bean. Well, you got two out of the three. We're going right up the ladder there. And, George, I don't know. I got a feeling you've got it. All right, Steve, slide the big one. Yeah! George, it's time to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. After you've made your decision, the star will reveal a hidden number and will multiply the $1,000 by whatever number is revealed at that time. It could be a 30. Should we throw that in the canal?
Howie or the gorilla?
Both of them. Did it stop?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Yeah. Now it's time, George, to choose a star.
I'm going to choose John, I think.
All right, John. Time for you to reveal.
You sure know, George?
The hidden number. It is a 20. $20,000. What you think? All right. Now, let's see. You're 6'4". I can't see any of the stars here. Let's see. How about... Now, wait a minute. You stand here. You stand, and I'll stand here, okay? All right. Good luck to you. Dance blank. That's D-A-N-C-E blank.
dance blank. George, John is ready to collect the $20,000. All you have to do is match him. How do you do that with dance blank?
Dance fever.
Fever. Sir. Well, the audience is yaying you. Let's turn around right now. Would you just step that? Sir. Thank you very much.
Gets a 96. Nice costume, good energy, and a lot of originality, George.
96. You've done that show too, huh? All right, he says Dance Fever will match you and collect the $20,000. John, what do you say?
I've done that show too, and I'll give you 100, George. Actually, I'll give you 20,000. Fever!
Yeah! $21,725. Congratulations, and we'll be back with George and our stars right after this. Here we go. We're going to find out which of the stars had the big number. All right, would you all grab your tabs, please? Ready, set, go. Give it a yank. Go.
Howie!
Oh, Howie!
That would have been an adventurous move, though,
right,
George.
Indeed. All right, champ, we'll see you tomorrow. Stars, you were wonderful. We'll see you tomorrow. Gene Raven inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Babbitt saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares there. Attaboy.
A member of our studio audience will receive Whirlpool's microwave oven with a microcomputer push-button control. Program all cooking cycles, times, and power with a touch of your fingertip. Convenient defrost guide and bi-level cooking rack furnished by Whirlpool. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.